You may have first known her as DJ Tanner on Full House, but today we know Candace Cameron Bure as an actress, mother, executive producer, and in her latest role as Kay Albright in the film Unsung Hero, where Candace tells the real-life story of the Grammy Award-winning band For King and Country, which is a story of faith, family, and compassion in an industry that needs more of it. We read the books, we bought the things. We thought we were ready. And then life took our plans and changed them. I'm Karen, I'm Victoria's mommy, and I work in tech.
And I'm Pamela. I have a baby boy named Ford, and I'm a journalist. And although we're both first-time working moms, we're actually pretty different.
And that's totally okay. Because we both agree that our most important work is raising our kids. We really need each other and can only get through this together. Welcome to Motherish Moments. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Motherish. I'm super, super, super excited about today's guest. I'm a personal fan myself, and so I am getting all the jitters down to go through with this chat because I never, ever, ever imagined that we would be doing this. So, but first, before we get started with Candace, I'll jump into my Motherish moment. So, Victoria this week, she's giving me 5 years old all over again. I mean, really intense. So her big deal this week is that all my friends are switching to big kid car seats. And I'm like, okay, Karen, no, this is not happening for you yet. And so she's like, I can handle it. I can handle the big girl car seat. And so I spiraled, as we do as moms sometimes, where we're like, is she ready? Maybe she's ready and I'm not getting the signs. And is it me? And then of course I went down an even like worse spiral because I was like looking at like the videos of like car crash dummy tests, whatever. And I'm like, okay, no. My decision and my gut feeling is that it's not time yet. So instead, I spent an unnecessary amount of money on a new car seat that looks like a big girl car seat, but it still has the harness. And I'm like, that was also unnecessary, but you know what? Whatever. She's my only child. I'm like living in it. I'm just like, I'm just a side character to like her world. But anyway, I'm sure Candace, for you, your kids are much older, but what my understanding is like bigger kids, bigger problems, bigger dilemmas. I don't know, but maybe not. I don't know.
That's so cute, man. I remember those days. And I think you made a really good decision, by the way. I'm like, if you could afford it and it gave you a better peace of mind and it helped her feel like a big girl, I think that was great. Good mothering there.
Thank you. Thank you. Do you have any like moment you can reflect on with your, like, how does it feel in your age?
I know. So my kids are all in their 20s. I have one that still lives at home, but I travel a lot. So I'm not even at home anymore all the time. And our middle son got married this year. And so my mom's story for this week was talking to my son about marriage because, you know, they're brand new, newlyweds, only like 4 months in. So it was like, how's it going? And, you know, my son was like, you know, well, we, you know, had this hiccup this weekend. So we're trying to figure out our communication style and how we can help foresee some of the issues that we had, but by better communicating. And so it feels very, like, it feels awesome, but so different to be on the other side of mothering when you are just listening and then you get to answer or give an opinion when you're asked to. And for me, I mean, this weekend was great because my son was like, yeah, what would you do in this case? Like, how do you think I could be more helpful in that way? So we had some good conversations, but yeah, they're like different because I don't have to do the day-to-day needs when they were little.
Something that you said reminds me of a phrase that I hear often, which is in motherhood, it's not that you have to, it's that you get to.
You get to.
It's such a privilege, even though it's extremely hard. And that I would love to kind of tie into, like, you know, let's talk about Unsung Hero, because the mother of this family, like the way she was depicted, I mean, it was incredible. Can you talk to us a little bit about the origin of the project and how it all came about?
I would love to. So I've known the Smallbone family for about 10 years, and they are exactly what you see and what you'd hope they are if you, you know, love their music. They are incredible. And so they had told me that they share their family story on stage all the time and for so many years. And they had been encouraged along the way to either write it in a book or maybe tell it as a movie. And so they came to me and my company and they said, hey, we're thinking to make this story into a feature film. And would you want to be a part of it? And I read that script and it was just incredible. And I didn't even know the origin story of their entire family and their very humble beginnings in Australia. They were very successful. Their dad was there. And then they pretty much lost everything. And they moved to the U.S. to pick up their dad's career, but everything kept falling through. So this whole movie was about their journey, putting the pieces back together. It was about this amazing prayer life that they had, about miracles happening. And their mom made life an adventure because they really didn't know what tomorrow was going to bring. And so to see Helen be that the glue that was holding their family together when they just kept getting one no, one discouragement, another bump in the road, one after another, is quite remarkable. And so she is the unsung hero of this story. And I thought, I mean, I've been in family entertainment my whole life. These are the stories I love to tell and the stories I love to be a part of. So anyway, I helped produce this film, and then I'm also in the film, which was just the cherry on top.
Yeah, that's so amazing. I don't want to give away too much, obviously, because I do want people to go see it. The movie is in theaters now, so you can check it out. But there's one part, no, there are two parts that really, really like spoke to me of how much you have to dig sometimes when you're a mom and you're dealing with like hard moments and your kids are there. And if you really kind of just show a more unfiltered version, it could be really hard. So the one scene when they first got to the house, and then, you know, again, I'm not giving away too much, but there was a situation where they didn't have anywhere to sleep, like actual beds, and the mom turned it into, you know, something exciting and adventurous. And I'm just like, man, and it's a good reminder for us, you know, no matter what stage you're in of motherhood, you know, there are moments that are hard and your kids are there and they don't know that now is not the moment, right? But like, you have to find a way to make it nicer and almost even like gamify sometimes, because then they'll feel safe and secure, which is ultimately, you know, our job. But that was so nicely done. I really loved that part. And the second part that also stuck out to me, when she kept trying to have this conversation with her husband in the kitchen and the kids are like, but this is broken, but this is that. And literally I'm like, this is my life every day at 5:30 p.m. It was so well done. What are you hoping that audiences take away from seeing the film?
I really hope that they'll be encouraged, not only their own life, but like as moms and dads, as families, like they were teammates. They were doing it together. That for me was really inspirational. I love that through the hardships, the mom and dad like brought the kids into it and said, hey, here's what we're going through. They didn't try to hide it from them. They said, we're part of a team and we're a family. And so we're going to help work through this together. And so I hope that is inspiring for people in itself. I love the quote in the movie that says, your family isn't in the way. Your family is the way. And that's because they treated it as teammates and they were all in together. And I hope people walk away wanting to be just a better friend, a better parent, a better employer. Like all those things, they were the way it was dealt with in the movie. And by the way, it's all true. It's a true story. So all of the miracles that happened are very much true, but you can't celebrate the miracle without seeing the hard parts. And the movie also doesn't shy away from that. So you see mom and dad having an argument. You see mom getting frustrated with the kids and screaming into her pillow because she just can't take another second of it.
Oh, I felt that scene. Then, I felt that scene.
Me too.
But I was like, oh, yeah. Yeah.
But then it was like, for me, one of those really impactful scenes was when it was burn the ships. It was kind of like, we could turn back. We could go back right now. But if we go back, we're just going to be at the same starting place. So we're going to move forward. We're going to take another step forward and forge ahead. And that to me, especially within family life, like a mom needs to hear that every day. Like, I don't have to have it perfect. I don't have to have it all pretty and wrapped up in a bow. I just need to take a step forward, like stop looking back and like, let's just one step at a time forward.
And we get a fresh start every day. At least whenever I've gone through some, you know, harder moments and stuff in my journey as a mom, like at the end of the day, sometimes you'll be like, man, today was really hard. But the following morning, you got a fresh start, you know, and you can try again. And luckily, kids are so resilient. I think that the film also showed that. Like,
yeah.
These kids in the middle of everything, they were shining in such a way that was just really, really beautiful. So it was really well done. The other thing that stood out to me is that the concept of the story and all the sacrifice is really relevant across various cultures, you know? I mean, at least I come from an immigrant family. My parents, you know, left Peru with very little to come here and struggle. And then, like, shortly after, I was like, surprise, baby, you know? And it's never, for families that are struggling that way, it's never the right time. It's never the right, you know, things are not going to be perfect, but you power through and like a team the way they
did.
So that
was exactly.
Well, thank you so much, Candace. Thank you for being on Motherish. Thank you for,
you're welcome.
You know, for sharing this moment with us. You know, I hope everybody will check out the film Unsung Hero. Candace, is there anything else you want to share with our Motherish audience before you go?
Oh, well, thanks for having me on. I always love talking about all things mom, even though I am grown up children now. You know, the other thing is we would love for you to check out the movie Unsung Hero. And you can also check out my podcast, the Candace Cameron Bure podcast, which is wherever you listen to your podcasts or on YouTube.
We will make sure to check it out and we'll share this with all of our Motherish community. Thank you so much.
Thanks so much.